Joining us now with more is Chief of Maryland's Highway Safety Office, Tom Gianni. Good morning, Tom.
Good morning.
Thank you so much for being with us.
Thank you for having me.
I want to start here because it's timely. We just had a situation on the Bay Bridge on Friday with a truck that, from what we understand, we don't know why, hit a woman in a car. Her car went over the bridge. Luckily, she survived, but it's very timely when we're talking about this story. I mean, this program. Tell us about what you think it could teach drivers on either end.
Well, I think this incident that occurred on the Bay Bridge certainly illustrates the dangers of coming up against a big truck like that. Without knowing all the facts, it certainly points out that when you come up against a big vehicle, generally you're going to lose. Aggressive driving has been with us for quite some time, and it involves things like speeding and weaving in and out of traffic, being rude and pushy, and it usually has pretty dire consequences when there's a crash, either some serious injuries or can result in fatality.
Now, a lot of these things, I'm sure, are things that we hope that people know, but what are some of the simple things that you explain to people, let's take aggressive driving, about what they should and shouldn't do when they're out on the road?
You know, it's all about trying to get to your destination on time, and people should leave a little more time when they leave their home. If they leave a little more time, I think the pressure comes down to get to your destination on time, and you're not as in a hurry. And that's what usually happens, and people become selfish. It becomes all about me. I have to get where I'm going, and I don't care about how I get there. So it becomes dangerous.
Are there some specific skills? I know Robbie talked about a few of them in the package, but are there some specific skills that you tell people when it comes to big rigs, for example, in driving, you know, in the vicinity of a big rig, some specific things that they could learn that could save their lives, really?
Absolutely. Those vehicles can weigh up to 80,000 pounds, and the laws of physics tell us they don't stop as fast as a car, nor are they as nimble as a passenger car. So you have to leave an awful lot of distance between you and that vehicle. You have to stay out of their blind spots, and you certainly don't want to pull in front of them or cut them off because, as I said, they're not as nimble, and if they have to come to a stop quickly, generally it's not going to happen as you would like.
And we've been talking all about kind of driver-focused tips and things like that. Are you all talking a lot about maybe different laws that we could see changed, not just so much on the driver's end, but in terms of the state and what they do with the laws?
Well, we welcome two new laws starting on October 1st. One will require that you buckle up in all seating positions in a vehicle. There's no better defense against a drunk driver or an aggressive driver than wearing your seatbelt, because seatbelts do save lives. The other law we will see starting October 1st is a primary law for handheld cell phones and texting. So what that means is if a police officer sees you on your handheld cell phone or texting, he or she needs no other reason to pull you over and cite you.
Always very good advice. Stay off that phone.
Distracted driving coupled with aggressive driving, it's a bad mix.
All right. Tom Gianni, welcoming. Thank you so much. We appreciate all your tips.